Hey everyone, so it has been a month since the last time that I sat down and filmed a video, so this is slightly weird for me. I'm kind of out of, you know, practice with it, but I just kind of wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about what the last month of, like, sustain and maintaining my weight has kind of looked like, how successful I've been, you know, some of the struggles that I've had, and that type of thing, just so that you guys can keep updated. So I have been able to maintain my weight. Basically, I've kind of been jumping back and forth between like the 133 and the 135 pound wise, so it's kind of like, you know, depends on my diet and all that type of things. So I'm not really concerned because I haven't really gone above 135 yet. So it's like, you know, there was one day where I weighed in and it was like 135.4 or something like that, but then like within 2 days it was back down to under 135. So I'm not really, like, that seems normal to me to kind of have a little bit of a variation depending on, like, you know, water intake and salt intake and all that various stuff that kind of, you know, affects how much you weigh. So I've been able to maintain my weight, which is great. I had a coaching session on June 8th, and that was my last coaching session, which was a little bit weird because my membership was up June 21st. And when we scheduled our coaching sessions, I was scheduled for June 8th and I was scheduled for June 22nd. So I had the coaching session on June 28th and I kind of talked with my coach about, you know, some of the things that I had been frustrated with since, you know, as you guys may know, with Sustain, I was slightly frustrated with the way that meal plan was presented to me and, you know, that whole situation. So we kind of talked through that a little bit, and then he was like, yeah, and I know that your membership is coming up due. And I was like, yeah, I'm like, just to let you know, I will not be renewing my membership. I was like, I think that I can do this on my own. I said, I don't really feel like I need the coaching to motivate myself. Like, I don't need the coaching to hold me accountable. So we're not going to really have anything to talk about. So I just don't think I'm going to renew. Like, I'm not going to spend the money to re-up my membership when I don't need it and I'm not really getting anything out of it anymore. I didn't say that last part because that seemed a little bit mean to say to him, but so I kind of did that, and I was then unsure if we were going to have the coaching session on the 22nd still or not. I mean, he expressed disappointment on June 8th about me not renewing my membership, and I can tell that he was, you know, slightly upset about it, not like mad at me, but just kind of like, oh, well, okay, whatever. Like, I don't know if he took it as an insult or what, but he never called on the 22nd, so I guess that was my last one then. So I am now officially no longer a profile member. That doesn't mean that I'm not using what profile taught me, and I'm not following like a strict profile plan anymore. Like, I am not doing like, oh, I get 5 starches and I get this. Like, I have switched over to just focusing on making sure that my macro goals are in order. So I know what my macro goals are, I know what my calorie goals are for the day, and I just track all my food on MyFitnessPal and make sure that I stay, you know, close to those goals so that I'm not overeating. But it's not like 5 starches, 4 fruits, you know, like, it's not really like that. Like, I make sure that I get my 4 cups of veggies in every day, and I do make sure that I get at least 3 servings of fruit in, because I don't want all my calories to be coming from like starches or fats. But so that's like kind of like my guideline, is I have to at least have 3 servings of fruit and 4 cups of vegetables, and that way then I can kind of make sure that I'm staying healthy while still broadening my food choices. So that is kind of how my, like, day-to-day life has gone, is it's not quite so much, you know. And that was, to be honest, that was kind of the thing that bugged me about profile when I first started, was that it was just follow the plan and you'll be fine. Like, I heard that multiple times, just follow the plan, just follow the plan. But I wanted to know why. Like, why is it this many fruits? Why is it this many starches? Why is it, you know, like, that kind of thing? And I don't feel like there was a lot of education in terms of the why behind, you know, what made a good fat and a bad fat and that type of thing. So that was a little bit, and kind of one of those things that maybe if I had the right transition through ADAPT, that's where that would have maybe happened. Or maybe it would have been something if I had in-person coaching where that would have been more of a natural flow to conversation, where the phone coaching tended to be really repetitive. So I'm not quite sure how I feel about, you know, that. I'm glad that I started counting my macros really early into starting Profile. Like, I started counting macros back in, like, Reboot and stuff. Just because I knew that eventually was going to be how my diet is going to go. Because you can't stick to 5 starches, 4 fruits, 6 servings of fat. Like, that's just not, like, really a sustainable way to live. Because then you're always kind of like, oh, well, I can't have any more starch. I can only have another fruit. Where now I can kind of go, well, I'd rather have, you know, a piece of bread versus an apple. Or, you know, I can make those kind of decisions and still be within my macro goals. And that way then I can have some things that are not quite profile friendly, but still fit within my macros. And also what I started in the month of June is I started doing one cheat day a week. It actually ended up being Sunday most weeks, but I had one for my birthday, I had one for the day that we celebrated my birthday, and I had one for Father's Day, and then when you guys watch this video, I will be at the Mall of America with my mother and my sister. We're doing like a family shopping thing, and that is going to be a cheat day for me. On cheat days, I still log my food, but I just don't care. Like, I don't focus on the calories or the carbs or the macros or any of that. I log it just because I like the fact that I feel like if I stop logging, then I won't log the next day. Like, I just, the longer I can keep the streak going, the better it is for me. So that's good for me that I keep my streak going, because I know that once I break a habit, it's really hard for me to like restart it. So I still log on my cheat days. I just have let it, it doesn't matter to me if I'm way over on all my macro goals, because it's a cheat day. That's what it's for. I do have to admit though that on my cheat days this month, I did go really overboard. And that is because a lot of times it was like, this is the first time I'm having this in a year. So it was like the first time I had real pizza in a year. It was the first time I had real ice cream in a year. It was the first time that I had real chips in a year. It was, you know, like there was a lot of, okay, this is the first time I've done it. And so I kind of went a little crazy. You know, I had cookies, I had cupcakes, I had brownies. Like, I went a little nuts. But that's okay. I got it out of my system. And now I think that my cheat days are going to be, you know, a little bit more restrained than what they were in June. At least I'm hoping. I mean, like, they can't all be as, they were all like holiday type stuff, so they can't all be that big of a cheat day. Like, it's just not physically possible for me. So that is kind of where I'm at. For exercise, I have, you know, started working out 6 days a week in June, and I have been able to maintain that, which is really nice. I think that also kind of helped balance out some of those extreme cheat days, because I have been exercising a lot more. I also still take Kona for a walk every single day, and that has been going on for 2 months now, where I have not broken that streak once. So that is something that is also like, as long as I can keep the habit going, it's really a lot easier for me to maintain it. So that's like, every day is just kind of like, I have to do it today because that'll make it easier to do it tomorrow, and I can't let myself have any excuses as to why I can't do anything. So that has been working for me. Strangely, even though I haven't really lost weight and I've been kind of bouncing back in between like the 133 and the 135 numbers, I actually did lose an inch off of my hips and I lost an inch off of my waist. So I am obviously like toning up and building more muscle. I'm just not losing fat as fast as I am like converting it to muscle, which is fine. Like, that's why I'm not really focusing on the number on the scale anymore. It's going to be more focused on how I feel and how my clothes fit, and like the inches on my body is kind of like where I'm focused. I'm not gonna set any goals. Like, I'm not gonna go like, oh, I want to lose 2 inches by whatever. Like, that I'm going to let my body just do what it wants to do naturally and keep working out and take it a little bit slower and not push myself as hard. It was also really strange because, like, this week was, like, the 1 year anniversary from when I started Profile. So, like, a year ago on, like, Thursday or Friday, it was my first official day of Profile, and I was 237 pounds, and now I'm like 133, 135 pounds, and I feel so much better. I am so happy that I joined Profile, and I'm so happy that, like, they were able to give me the tools that they gave me, but I really do feel like I can just do this on my own now. So that is where I'm at for the month of June. Like, exercise is going really well. I am kind of experimenting with cheat days and how that's gonna go. I'm not following a specific plan. I'm just counting my macros and making sure that, you know, my normal days are within my macro goals. And I'm really just enjoying buying new clothes and having a lot more fun and a lot more flexibility with my life and with my diet. So I will see you guys at the end of July now, and I will have another update for you. See you guys then.